Hello everyone, welcome to MATLAB Simulink Essentials. In this video, we will see the simulation for semi-converter. For that, we will use different components present in the library browser. This is the circuit diagram for single phase semi-converter, and this bridge configuration consists of two thyristors and two diodes, and one freewheeling diode is connected in parallel with this RL load. So we will do the connection similar to the circuit diagram. So let us start with AC voltage source. Change here the peak amplitude to 325 volts and frequency to 50 Hz. Now take the thyristor present in the specialized power system library. Remove the measurement port as it is not required. Rotate this block and we will rename this block as thyristor T1. Now make the copy of this block. Now take the diode present in the specialized power system library. Remove the measurement port of this diode as well. Let us rename this block as diode D1. Make the copy of this diode D1 and now do the appropriate connections. Connect this AC source to this bridge configuration. Take series RLC branch. Open this block. Let us consider RL type of load with resistance of 20 ohms and inductance of 50 mH. Rotate this block and connect it across this bridge configuration. Now take another diode which will act as a freewheeling diode, so connect it across the in parallel with this load. Take voltage measurement block. We will take another current measurement block as well to measure the current flowing through this load. Connect this voltage measurement block across this load. Make the copy of this block and connect it across this supply side. Now take the scope block. Change the number of input ports of this scope block to 3. And now connect these signals. You can give the name to each signal. Now take the pulse generator block, open it, and we will change this period of this pulse generator to 20 milliseconds. So we can also write it as 1 divided by 50 Hz. And for this first block, we will give the phase delay as 3.33 milliseconds. as a phase delay or as a firing angle, which will come out to be 60 degrees. Connect this to this first thyristor. Make the copy of this pulse generator block and change here the phase delay to 13.33. Because this thyristor will conduct in the negative half cycle, so we have added here 10 milliseconds plus 3.33, which will give us 13.33 milliseconds, or 180 degree plus 60 degree, which will give us this phase delay. Now take the power guy block. Save the file. We will take the runtime as 0.08 seconds. Save the changes and run the simulation. Open the scope block to view the waveforms. So we will make some changes here. Save the changes and run the simulation. So here you can observe, this is our input waveform. Here is the output voltage across the load side, and this is the current flowing through this load. So in the positive half cycle of the AC supply, when gate pulse is applied to this thyristor T1, it starts conducting, and in this positive half cycle, this thyristor T1 and D1 will conduct. So output voltage waveform will appear something like this, and this is the corresponding current waveform. So during this positive half cycle of the AC supply, this inductor will store the energy. So as soon as this positive cycle ends, at that time, this diode D1 will get turned off along with this thyristor T1. So this inductor will release its energy through this freewheeling diode D3. So here you can observe at omega t equals to pi or at 10 milliseconds, our voltage is zero, but current is having a non-zero value. And after that, this waveform of current is decreasing in nature. So in the negative half cycle of the AC supply, when a gate pulse is applied to this thyristor T2, it starts conducting along with this diode D2. So corresponding waveform you can observe here, and this is the current waveform. So you can see here that our current waveform is continuous in nature because it is not touching zero anywhere. So that's all from this video. Check out the description box for the quiz and do answer them in the comment section. Thank you for watching this video. Like, share and subscribe to the channel Start Scratch, and do check out our other videos to learn similar skills through our bite-sized content.